We did have a lot of problems with the candles anyway. The candles were burned down very quickly. We would have to refuel every time to the continuity of the... And they give off an enormous amount of smoke as well, atmospheric smoke. So when you got the scene, you would open all the windows, put the plenums on, extract all the dirt and dust and the smell, because people, you know, eats up oxygen.
We had so many candles, I mean, there was no oxygen in the room, so you're like falling asleep.
So, yes, everything you had to sort of shut down, regroup and go back to number one and go through the whole process again.
You are sometimes lonely.
Sometimes.
The ambient light in the room is everything. Everything falls away too quickly. It's not shaped to it. Candlelight don't travel very far. I always say it was an illusion. If you see five candles there, you're sold the idea that the light's coming from the candles. And if you look at some of the scenes, how was they so bright in the background? We had a bit of ambience bounce off a ceiling to bring it up, because the four candles or five candles you see, behind them were 20 candles in a film can. But you don't see them. You've been sold that idea that the candles are flickering. They are lighting it, but there's a bit of a backup there.
Lou had this idea of pointing reflectors to the ceiling of these rather stately homes because people want to burn the place down. There's quite a lot of smoke produced from these candles and a fair amount of heat. You have to be careful. And there was not a set built in that movie. There were all real locations, priceless locations, often open to the public every day. That ambient light was reflected back into the set itself. There's still a semblance of some illumination in the background, so you're still reading the wallpaper, the texture of the door, the paint, the carpets, the ceiling. The whole thing is there recorded at a very low level, but conceivably real enough to believe that it looked real.